Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab video on digital relative humidity sensing. In this video, we'll cover the basic knowledge needed to get started with using Texas Instruments' family of integrated digital relative humidity and temperature sensors. To begin learning about our humidity sensors, we first have to understand the different ways humidity can be represented. The fundamental goal of either is to put an intrinsic value on the amount of water the atmosphere is holding. Absolute humidity is the measure of water vapor in the air, regardless of the temperature, and is expressed as grams of moisture per cubic meter. Relative humidity is expressed as a percentage, and its equation accounts for the changes in atmospheric temperature. When temperatures are frigid, the atmosphere isn't able to retain much water, and the inverse is true as temperatures increase. Dew point is a temperature that represents the point at which air must be cooled for condensation to occur. Finally, the psychrometric chart is widely used in our industry to visualize what combinations of temperature and humidity create a comfort zone for humans. Among all the options for representing humidity, the majority of humidity sensors output relative humidity. Since the environments in which they are used are ever-changing and there's always a need to track the combination of temperature and humidity. A humidity sensor is a device which measures the amount of water vapor present in the environment it's exposed to. The humidity sensor actually measures pressure and temperature or a change in electrical or mechanical condition from which absolute or relative humidity is calculated. Traditionally, measurements from analog humidity sensors were used to study and predict weather, and over time has found its way into several products we use daily. In the last decade, as systems have become more integrated, connected, and faster, a true need for digital humidity sensors emerged as they provide not only a wired interface to a larger system, it also provides greater accuracy, smaller size, low cost, and power consumption as compared to previous analog implementations in the past. Another major issue the digital humidity sensor resolves is the package opening size needed to measure moisture in the air. The package opening allows for the polyamide to react with the moisture in the air, and the amount of moisture absorbed is then translated into a resistance, voltage, or digital output. With advancements in digital humidity sensor technology, the polyamide area is reduced and provides a much smaller surface area while having greater accuracy. This allows a digital relative humidity sensor to drift less at high temperatures and humidity levels than an analog humidity sensor. The devices and systems we encounter in our everyday life use humidity sensors to prevent or detect when an environment is harmful. In the lower end of relative humidity, some systems such as CPAP machines need to ensure adequate temperature and humidity levels to prevent respiratory irritation while a patient is receiving treatment. As building automation advances, relative humidity sensors are used to provide a critical input to an environmental control system, such as the air conditioning in buildings for human comfort. These same principles are often applied to printers, industrial transport of goods, and manufacturing processes to ensure quality of production. On the higher end of relative humidity levels, these sensors are used in industrial settings to prevent corrosion or mechanical damage to motors and other critical components that are exposed to the environment. It's common for temperature and humidity to be logged for self-diagnostics or preventative maintenance in these applications. There are also instances where a system needs to monitor relative humidity across the full range. Humidity and temperature measurements from electromechanical gas sensors, for example, are used to calibrate air quality measurement systems that need to accurately output gas concentration. Now that you have a general understanding of humidity and how it can be used in applications, Texas Instruments offers a portal page to assist you in choosing the correct device and also provides several documents for reference when getting started developing your solution with our devices. First, the portal page will help you choose the right device for your application by allowing comparisons of devices and gives direct hyperlinks to each product page for datasheet and other technical reference material. Second, the datasheets of each of the individual parts TI offers has product-specific layout and handling guidelines due to the unique open cavity package. There is additional collateral for storage handling, optimization placement and layout, as well as programming techniques. Online technical support is also available through Texas Instruments E2E forum and FAQ section. This forum is specifically for developers to quickly get assistance and answers to questions that arise during development. For communication with our devices, we offer an EVM GUI that's compatible with our family of EVMs, SDK files for TI's line of processors, and header and .c files that can be used for both TI and non-TI processors. InnerGIA also comes preloaded with code examples And finally, we also have a downloadable library for Arduino. TI also has a large list of system-level designs that use humidity and can give you more insight for how you can use humidity sensors to enhance your system, whether it be for low-power applications, supporting long-distance communication, or calibrating gas sensors. Thank you for watching this video on humidity sensing, and be sure to download this presentation for direct links to the documents and tools mentioned. We also have other resources and products at ti.com/humidity.